As you can see from the title of the slide, I am just using some of the words that are becoming buzzwords in the Arab world right now. We are only talking about revolutions and everything. So what we are doing in Islamic marketing, actually, we are creating a revolution. That revolution is against consumerism. Now, how would we define consumerism? If you Google it, if you look at Wikipedia, at any other dictionary, you'll find that consumerism, at the end, evaluates man or to evaluate humans based on what they consume and about how much they consume. So what we are doing in Islamic marketing, we are saying that the value of a person, the value of a man, the value of a woman is not related to the type of their consumption, to how much they consume and to what they consume. What we are going to do is instead of maximization of consumption, just instead of one car, you have two cars, three cars. Instead of one house, you have two houses, three houses. Instead of one suit or one thobe like this one can do, you have so many others. You only take what you need. And this is what I am trying and what we are trying, what Islamic marketing has been trying to create within the last 3 years. To say that we achieved a lot of success, we have achieved just for you to be here. We have from so many countries, 25 countries, people coming to present and to talk about Islamic marketing that really shows us how much interest that is being created right now in the world. So from now on, what we are going to do, inshallah, we will try to convince the world that my value, that your value, that my worth, that your worth is by no means related to how much we own or to how much we consume. It is only what our value should be determined by how much we make this world a better place. It is if we keep intaking, taking and consuming all the time, what we are going to do, we are going to leave nothing for generations to come. So from now on, I promise myself, actually I did promise myself a while ago when I started the General of Islamic Marketing, and I hope many of you will do that. We need to do is, instead of what we need to do is we need to have not modesty, what we need to do is to reduce everything that we do, and hopefully at the end, ultimately, we will be able to convince a larger group of people, of researchers, and this will become a trend in the world. What we are going to do, inshallah, through this conference and the coming conferences of next year and the year after that, is we want to bring ethics back to marketing, because marketing has right now, it is devoid of any, the only driving force behind marketing in the world right now is how to take more money of consumers. It doesn't matter if that destroys the health of children, the health of the young people, the health of a nation as a whole. What we need to do is we need to tell the world marketers, please stop. That is really enough. We need to take into consideration what's going to happen in the world as a whole in the long term. So ethical consumption, considerate consumption, the well-being of future generations to come, these are really main concepts of Islamic marketing. Also, what we need to take into consideration is, I would like to add to what Dr. Fatima explained about accreditation. Right now, the accreditation market is really fragmented. For example, if you go to France, anybody can go to the municipality and they will get a license. This is what Dr. Sudim is going to talk about. You take a license and straight away you are able to give licenses. You say this product is halal and that product is not halal. So anybody can do it. There are no regulations, no controls whatsoever. I know there have been some efforts, but the efforts themselves are really fragmented. What we need to do is we need to have some kind of a driving force behind us. We need institutions, we need governments. It is, we do not, if only purely from an economic perspective, from cash perspective, the government or the institution that takes the lead on accreditation in the world will be making a huge amount of money. What we discussed in Islamic marketing is that in France, 1 kilo of meat, only to get the word halal, to stamp the word halal, it is €1, which is 5 dirhams. So imagine how many kilos of meat are certified as halal in the world right now. It is a huge economic resource. It will really help the country or group of countries that go into halal accreditation. For example, if we talk about the Gulf, it will be a totally alternative source of income. Maybe I'm not saying that to replace oil, but it definitely will be something that's within that range. An important thing about this as an alternative source is that the United Arab Emirates and the Gulf countries, the GCC countries, they have a lot of good reputation. So when you say it is manufactured in the United Arab Emirates, or it is certified by the United Arab Emirates, the reputation is so good outside. Everybody will accept that because this country and this region has credibility all over the world. So what we are trying to do, inshallah, within this world, we'll take it step by step. We will just start now by creating momentum, by creating interest in the world as a whole. We are now contacting governments. We are contacting large organizations and large institutions. And I would really like to invite all of you to be part of that effort. Because today here all of you are the leaders, all of you are the pioneers of this field. What you are going to write today, what you are going to your papers, your publications, your books, they are going to be the guidelines for all the researchers to come after a while, because you are drawing the roadmap for everything that everybody that's going to work on in the later, inshallah. A really important thing is that we need to work on giving some motivations to people. Why should people work on this one? I know maybe many of us here, they come for motivation because I want this, I believe in this. Some people here come for research. But you know, some people come for research, it's okay. Some people come out of belief, it's okay. But other people, we need to show them the economic value of Islamic marketing. That is going to take some time, maybe 5 years, 10 years, because our plan is actually a long term, over the 10 years, inshallah. Over the 10 years, what you are going to see is the Journal of Islamic Marketing is going to be at least a B journal, at least, minimum B journal, inshallah, if not an A. But that cannot be done without your help and without your support and without your papers and publications and all types of form and your attending conferences, inshallah. During the conference, inshallah, here, the 85 presentations that we are going to have, we hope that they will represent some kind of, at the end of the conference, we are going to circulate some kind of a document. It is going to be the Islamic marketing ethical, something like that, guidelines. And we are going to try to publicize that document. It's going to be like a code of ethics. How should marketers, both as academics and as practitioners, how should they practice marketing as a whole? It is not going to be presented as, it is like, this is, it's not going to be presented as a religious document. It is going to be presented as an alternative economic model. And that way, I think that's how we should be thinking about it. By this, I have taken some of your time before. Now I think I over-exercised my right. Thank you for your time and for your patience.